What's the German government's response to US President Donald Trump's assertion that he's implementing a travel ban excluding the UK, but it applies to all the European countries?
Well, let me say something very, very general. The virus does make a difference between the citizenships or the ethnic origin of the human beings that are being attacked, and I think we shouldn't make a difference. So we are in this together. This is also in testing and trying times, an opportunity for all of us as the international community to stand in solidarity, to support the weakest, to engage in cooperation and not in closing down borders. And we believe, and the President of the European Commission, Mrs. von der Leyen, of the European Union, and also the German government have made very clear that the decision taken by the US President, in our view, is wrong.
Yeah.
Because it's the wrong approach. This is not the moment for nationalism. This is not the moment for egoism. This is not the moment for selfishness. This is the moment for empathy and solidarity. And I am very much convinced, and I'm very optimistic, that we will overcome, that we will make it, that we will win the fight against this virus, if we stand together and not separate ourselves and play games of extremism, of populism, and of nationalism. When you look at the graphs, when you look at a graph where, in terms of the time and the exponential rise of the infections, all the countries are pretty much in the same territory, because the virus is a virus that doesn't make any difference between Italians, Germans, Chinese, or South Africans, for that matter. It is a virus that attacks a human being irrespective of the color of your skin or the passport you hold. That is it. That, I think, is the reason why it is so important that we react as an international community, as human beings as a whole, and don't make any distinctions there. Now, we have a situation in Germany where the relationship between the number of deaths on the one hand side and the number of confirmed infections is lower than in any other place. I think we have 6 confirmed deaths and something around 2,500 confirmed cases, which comes up to a mortality rate that is less than 1%. I don't think that the German people are healthier than others or more resilient. I think it has to do with the fact that from the beginning in Germany, there was a widespread rollout of tests and test kit to make sure that wherever we have a suspicion, we have a test case so that we can detect where we stand. And that is exactly the reason why we decided with the South African government to give them 2.5 million rand just to make sure that they can acquire the test kits they need in order to make sure that, you know, the reaction, the appropriate measured reaction by the South African government to the spread of the virus, which I think is inevitable, but we can delay it considerably by taking informed decision, by knowing what the state of the spread of the virus is. And for that, it is important that people that are in suspicion get the chance to be tested. Indeed, I can tell you now that decisions are being made to make sure that the social distancing, the need for the people to not spread the virus further in order to delay it, in order to give our health institutions the chance to cope with the situation, has brought about new decisions. We just heard that in the capital of Berlin, schools will be closed beginning on Monday. I suppose that in many other of our federal states, the same decisions are going to be taken. We do have drastic measures to bring down the risk of the spread of the virus in sports, in the German Bundesliga and elsewhere. And we believe, and we do have some experience in China and elsewhere, that is a very proper mechanism to bring down the risk or the speed of the spread of the virus.
Your Excellency, you're almost repeating what the Chancellor said about 2 days ago, saying we're playing for time. And this kind of response has created some sort of unease, especially in South Africa as well, where there are that kind of sentiment that the president is playing for time. How safe is this strategy?
Well, we are not playing for time. We are taking resolute measures to make sure that the virus spreads as slowly as is humanly possible. And we do that in safeguarding and respecting the values of a liberal, of a democratic society. So the first thing to do is to educate our people, to tell them what is good for them, what is good for their families, and what is good for society at large. And that is, of course, to do what is necessary in your personal hygiene and to make sure that if you involuntarily carry the virus in you, you make sure that you don't spread it to the people that are important to you. So in a sense, this is also about nation building. This is about empathy. This is about solidarity. This is about standing as one and taking responsibilities as an individual for the whole of society.